For our next Tech Talk, please welcome Thijs van As, Lead Product Manager of Google Flights.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Thijs van As, and I'm leading product management for Google Flights. And I'm excited that I will be sharing some trends in consumer behavior that we've observed over the last few years with you today, as well as some examples of how we leverage machine learning to create rich user experiences for travelers that use all of our different products. Now, as all of you in this room know, people spend a ton of time dreaming about their upcoming travels and also spending a lot of time saving up for these upcoming travels. And you know, all this time and energy that goes into this is not only causing a lot of excitement, but it's also causing a lot of stress and anxiety. Because people first need to figure out where's their next holiday going to be, how do they get there, where are they going to stay, what are the things that they need to do, how much is it going to cost. And all of this stress and anxiety is actually adding quite some hurdles to the travel planning process. And I'm personally very excited to work on products to actually take away some of this stress during the travel planning. Now, add to that the rise of mobile over the past few years. As we all know, information is accessible everywhere right now. Everybody has a smartphone in their pocket, and you can get to anything at any moment. And for lots of travel companies, this has resulted in new opportunities to connect with users and engage them in new kind of services. What I think is really important, though, is that while we create these new services and applications, that we keep the traveler and their needs at the center of all of it. Now, what we've seen over the years is that people start to come to Google when their travel journey begins. It typically starts with stuff like things to do in Amsterdam, flights to Brussels, or the weather in Rome, and all these kind of related queries. And people do this over the course of a couple of weeks before they end up fully locking down on what their exact travel plans are. And why do people come to Google? They want to have all this information in order to build up confidence on their final decisions on which accommodation to book and which transportation, etc. Now, specifically with the rise of mobile, we've seen quite some trends in how these type of queries shifted over time. So in the last 2 years, we've seen queries for places to travel more than double. And what's even more impressive is queries for things to do around me or activities around me have increased by a whopping 6 times over the last 2 years. Now, it's very important that we realize this while we're building this new product. At the core of our business has always been user trust, high functionality, and high degree of data quality. And it's been our travel mission to provide to be the most trusted place that people can go to get all the useful information they need in order to make the right decisions for planning their trips. And for consumers, this means that we're working very hard on creating rich experiences that people get all the information they need to make a decision. At the same time, our goal is to identify the moments of intent where users are expressing what they need so that we can connect our partners at the moments when it matters most with our users so that they can provide their services in this flow. Now, as you might have seen earlier this week, we announced a new set of experiences. And this is not really a new set of experiences. What it basically was, we started unifying a lot of the individual travel products under a single interface focused around trip organization. And this has been an evolution that happened over the past year, because last year we already enabled some of these features on our mobile experiences that made it very easy for our users to switch from, for example, our hotel search product to our flight search product. And at the core of this, there are 3 aspects that are very important for us. The first one is comprehensiveness. We want to make sure that our users, at any moment where they are, that they have access to the highest quality of information and the full set of information. Then the second one is that we support our users across the full journey in which they're planning their trip. We know that booking a trip it doesn't happen like click, 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 and then you booked it in one hour. We see that on average, people spend like 5 to 6 weeks between they start to look for a trip and the moment they actually end up booking. And during those 5-6 weeks, people are using multiple devices, and they're using multiple products, and they're coming back over and over again to refine their search and to lock down on certain details of their trip. And we want to make sure that we can help people across all those different moments so that you can easily pick up where they left off across this journey. And then lastly, what we really believe in, that we want to help people organize their trips and plan their trips in a trip-centric way. No matter where you're planning, like a spring break or a weekend trip or a trip around the world, your trip is not just a flight or it's not just a hotel or planning your activities. All these things, they kind of go hand in hand. And we want to make sure that we help users easily digest these things and pick up where they left off in this context of a trip. And again, we believe that by focusing on these things, we can deliver value for our users by bringing transparency and delightful experiences, while at the same time providing a great platform how we can connect our partners that provide all these services to our users at the moments when they express their intents. Now, at the heart of many of our experiences is machine learning. And by leveraging the vast amounts of data that are available at Google, we can help be better at creating rich insights for travelers to give them better, more confidence while they're actually in this booking process. And at the same time, coming back to these moments of intent, we can define these moments with a lot higher quality than without using technologies like this. And next, I want to walk you through three examples of how we leverage machine learning in our products day to day and how this provides value for our users and for our partners. So by now, you might have heard either from my accent or from my name that I'm Dutch. That said, I live and work in Switzerland for quite a while now. And quite regularly, people that I know, they have been asking me, like, hey, you go to Amsterdam regularly. What does a flight from Zurich to Amsterdam cost? And what I used to tell them is like, well, if you find a flight for under 100 euros, you have quite a good deal. And if it's somewhere between 100 and 200 euros, then that's kind of typical. And if it's 400 or more, then you're probably looking at around Christmas. Now, we realized that these kind of questions, they're not just being asked by my friends. This is actually the core problem that people are having while they're booking a flight. People don't know what is a good price for a flight. And then once they get a sense of that, they don't know when is the right time to book. And this creates and adds a lot of stress and anxiety to this whole process of planning, where already all these complexities were taken into account. So we were focusing really hard on trying to help people with taking away a lot of this stress and creating this confidence that people know this is a reasonable price and now I'm ready to book and make the decision. So very happy that like 2 months ago, we launched a new type of price insight in Google Flights that helps people understand for almost every search that you do on Google Flights, whether prices are currently low, high, or typical compared to what we're used to. Now, how we build this, we leveraged a ton of the data that we had available about historic airfares, as well as ones that have been published for the future. And it's more complicated, maybe it doesn't seem easy, but it's definitely quite complicated. Because it's not just as simple as like taking the average price and saying like, well, the average is a fair price. Because as many of you know, there's all these kind of factors that go into the price of a flight. Like, is there a weekend during your trip? Are there holidays included? What's the time of the day? Are there nonstop flights? So we wanted to make sure that we actually give these insights based on the search that you're actually doing. So today, in Google Flights, when you, for example, say, I'm looking only for nonstop flights, or flights from a certain airline, or business class flights, we adjust this insight, and it shows up instantly with your search for almost every search that you do on Google Flights today. Now, this addresses the first part of the problem, and this is definitely the biggest part, like not knowing what is a good price for a flight.
The second part of the problem, not knowing when to book, this also adds a lot of anxiety. And this is, of course, a tricky part as well. So what we're doing here, we have several machine learning models that try to predict what is going to happen with this price. And one specific one that I want to highlight here that is perceived as very useful by our users is the prediction where we predict whether the price will not drop before the plane takes off. And when we have super high confidence, like more than 90%, that we're sure that the price won't drop before the plane takes off, we will tell the user in this interface that we highly predict that, so that they can feel a bit more at rest and say, like, okay, maybe I'm now ready to make the decision. I don't have to wait for the price to drop. So this is the, what's really nice is we didn't just do this for Google Flights. We also did this for our hotels experience. And so here you see some screenshots where we provide very similar or the same insights for in our hotels vertical. Now, this is the first example. And this example was really about people that are still in the researching phase. The next example that I want to talk about is when people are more in the stage when they're ready to book. And we all know when you're ready to book and you're looking at prices of flights or hotels, there's one thing that's super important. And that is that you're looking at accurate prices from the whole set of partners that offers these prices. So just last month, we launched a machine learning model for hotel ads that predicts whether a specific price point for a hotel that's provided by a partner is likely to be out of date or inaccurate. And when that model predicts that there's a high likelihood that the price is out of date, we do a query to that partner to make sure that we have the accurate price even before the user starts looking at them. And I think this is a super valuable part where we can make sure that the partners are represented in the best possible way in our products, as well as from the user perspective, that they are looking at the most accurate data so that they're ready to decide. And then the last example that I want to talk about is while the user is actually traveling. So we know that a lot of stress of traveling is actually happening the moment you're at the airport and between you got through the security and before your flight is taking off. People are checking their phone constantly. It's like, oh, is there a gate change? Is there a delay? Where do we need to be? Do I need to leave already? Or do I still have a bit of time? And for years, it has been possible to type in a flight number on Google.com and get the up-to-date status of your flight. What we added last year were two new features. The first one is that we started giving reasons for these delays. So this meant that those were the reasons that were published by the airline or by another authority, and we started showing them in our interface. The other aspect that we added here, we started doing predictions for whether a plane would be delayed, even if the airline hadn't told us so. And how we did this, we looked at millions and millions of past flight status updates that we've processed, and we looked at cases where we saw a plane that was delayed, and like, could we correlate it with any event, like another plane delay, happening anywhere else in the world or in the scheduling system? And this actually got us a lot of new insights and got us to build a model where we could fairly accurately predict whether a plane would be delayed by at least like 30 minutes, for example, even when this was not obvious the fact whether the incoming plane was delayed, because we all know that these airline schedules are super complicated. So sometimes there's like hidden correlations that are only made accessible by doing this kind of like machine learning. And this has been a feature that has been received a lot of praise from our users. So these were three examples of how we leverage machine learning in some of our consumer experiences to help create more confidence and create a better, like more delightful experience. And again, I want to highlight here that like at the end of it, what we try to do is take away a lot of the stress that comes with the planning of a trip and help the user in the best possible way to get through this and identify all their moments of intent in a very high-quality way so that at the moments when it matters and where they express their intent, we can connect the users of Google with the partners that are providing all these services. I hope these kind of examples were insightful for you and maybe even caused some inspiration for the projects that you are building. And I want to thank you very much for your time, and I'll be around afterwards for any discussions about this. Thank you.